Hi everyone, today we are discussing about crossbar switch configurations. In a non-blocking crossbar configuration, there are n square switching elements for n subscribers. When all the subscribers are engaged, only n by 2 switches are actually used to establish connections. Only n by 2. N means number of switches. 2 means connected links. For example, X and Y. Two links only. That means primarily it will use n by 2 formula. At the conference situations, we are using other formulas. The below table shows the values different design parameters for 4 non-blocking switches. These are the non-blocking crossband switching systems design parameters. NO, S, SC, E, EU, F, C, CCI 416 to 2.5, 12.50, 16, 0.5, 16, 50, 256. These are all the different parameters which is applying at the calculation point of data conversions, which is used in at the date calculation of used in at the point of data calculations. Here n equal to number of subscribers, s equal to number of switching elements, sc equal to switching capacity, c equal to total cost, EUF equal to equipment utilization factor. CCI equal to cost capacity index. Now we are entering to the major topics. A diagonal connection matrix for 4 subscribers is shown in below. For example, these are the 4 subscribers A, B, C and A dash, B dash, C dash. I am not indicating bars, but it is a diagonal connection. From the above switches or switch points are used to establish connection between 2 subscribers. For example, subscribers depending upon who initiated the call. For example, 1, clearly we are seeing 1. C wishes to call subscriber B, so CB will be energized. C wishes, that means C will calling to the B. The exchange of data route CB will be activated, or the propagation of CB route will be cleared, which is share information between C to B or B to C. Next example, D wishes to call subscriber A. That means A sending to the call, or A call to the, sorry, D call to the A. That means DA path, DA exchange route, DA propagation route will be energized. That means that will be activated. which is propagates the data information between D to A, IA to D. In this case, the crossband matrix reduce the matrix with n square by 2. Reduce the matrix with n square by 2. It is a formula. And the number of crossband reduces to n into n minus 1 by 2. These are all the internal formulas applying number of subscriber lines and number of deleting lines by 2. Then we are finding the number of tracks which will propagate data information continuously on the crossbar switching points. Clearly, we are also seeing another example, 8 into 3. This is the block diagram of 8 into 3 switches. This is the block diagram of 8 into 3 switches. Here we are observing 8 horizontal lines and 3 vertical lines and 3 inversion of vertical lines. That means both are internally connected. That's why we are using 3 lines: P, P bar, Q, Q bar, R, R bar, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. That means, for example, A and P are energized. That means the propagation link AP will be activated. For example, B and P dash will be energized or activated or on condition. That means the data will propagate through the crossbar exchange lines to P to P dash. Sorry, B to P dash. For example, if the F and R dash will be energized or activated, at that situation the data will propagate F to R dash or R dash to F. For example, if the data will be propagated C to Q bar or Q dash, so in that process Q bar will be activated. The propagation of data will propagate through the line of C Q bar. So these are the different examples how will data will propagate from horizontal to vertical planes. For example, a horizontal E will be activated at the same time vertical R will be activated. So the data will propagate horizontal E to vertical R. For example, the date and the subscriber points or subscriber links horizontal G and vertical P will be activated. So that means GP will be form a tracking line and it will share the information between devices. So these are the different crossbar switching techniques. Which will propagate the information in different manners. Already we know C wishes to call subscriber B. Not only C, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Just we are increasing crossbar switching lines, then automatically number of paths and number of data links and number of crossbar switches will be increases. When we are decreasing number of lines, then automatically number of crossbar lines will be decreases. So this is the main object of crossbar switch configurations. This is the main object of crossbar switch configurations. crossbar switch configurations. What is crossbar? When we are applying subscriber lines, both horizontal and vertical, not only horizontal, not only vertical. When we are applying subscriber lines, both horizontal and vertical, that's why it is called crossbar switches. Crossbar switches configurations. Crossbar switches configurations. So when we are arranged the data subscriber lines, both horizontal and vertical axis, and we will share the information between devices, that's why it is called crossbar switchy or switching configurations. This is the main object and working principle of crossbar switch configurations. Next class we are discussing other topic. Thank you.